and welcome to Miss Bailey's Daily Dose. Today we are going to be learning to describe movement and direction. So we're going to be looking at left and right, up, above, below, and some other ones. So, in front of, the robot is in front of the house. In front of. Now the robot is in between. He's in between the two flats. In between, that's where something's at the side of both sides of the thing in the middle. Next to, the robot is next to the house. Above, the robot is above the tree. The robot now is on the bike. The robot is in the box. He's inside of the box. The robot is going to walk through the cave. Through. The robot has walked over the bridge. Over the bridge. The robot is under the chair. Under the chair. The robot is behind the brick wall. He's behind the brick wall. So there's some of the main position and direction language that we need to know, that most of you will already know. Now we're gonna have a look at movements. So we're looking at going forwards, going backwards, going left, and going right. There's certain ways that we can work that out. So you can see the boy here, he's on a dance mat. One of those mats where you have to move your feet the same way as the arrows for it to work and for you to get the most points. So forward, so because he's facing this way, the arrow is going that way, so he's going forwards. If I was facing this way, if I was going forwards, I'd be going towards the camera. If I was going backwards, I'd be moving more towards my board. So we've got forwards, we've got backwards. Now, left and right is one of the things that lots of us get mixed up with. And the best thing to do is to get your index finger and your thumb out on both of your hands. Your left hand is the one that will make an L shape. Now I'm going to do it on the other side because I'm facing the other way. So your left will be here. What it will look like is this. So here's your left hand and you can see it has an L. So if you put your hands like this, the left makes an L. So you know that's your left hand. And then you've got your right hand that doesn't make an L. So we're going to have a little look at a video now that's going to help you remember your left and your right.
Now raise your left hand, said my teachers to the class. Then they asked us for our right hand, did it make me want to hide? Because our ears didn't know which one's my left or right side.
We'll help you learn that.
Left, right, left.
We'll help you learn right.
Right, left, right.
Did you know that if you hold up your left hand, your thumb and index finger make the shape of an L, and an L is for left.
First, raise your left hand.
Raise your left hand.
Now raise your right hand.
Raise your right hand.
Now tap your left foot.
Tap your left foot.
And tap your right
foot. Tap your right foot.
Now touch your left side.
Touch your left side.
And touch your right side.
Touch your right side.
We all have left and right
now
side.
Now raise your left hand, said my teachers to the class. Then they asked us for our right hand, and it made me want to hide. Because our ears didn't know which one's my left or right side.
We'll help you learn that.
Left, right, left.
We'll help you learn right.
Right, left, right.
Don't forget, if you hold up your left hand, your thumb and index finger make the shape of an L. And an L is for left.
First, raise your left hand.
Raise your left hand.
Now raise your right hand.
Raise your right hand.
Now tap your left
hand. Tap your left foot.
And tap your right hand.
Now touch your left side.
Left side.
Touch your right
side.
Right
side.
We all have left
and
right side.
Raise your right hand.
I can do that.
Now raise your left hand.
I can do that.
Tap your left foot.
I can do that.
Now tap your right foot.
I can do that.
Now jump to the left.
Jump, jump, jump. to the right. Jump, jump, jump. Jump to the left. Jump to the right. Now I think I got it. Now I got it right.
Now raise your left hand, said my teachers to the class.
Oh, yeah.
And they asked as far as my hands, and I lifted mine with pride. Because now I knew which hands were on my left and right side.
We'll help you learn that.
Left, right, left.
We'll help you learn right.
Right, left, right.
You can learn them now, won't take too long.
So now, to check that you know your left and your right, we're going to do the cha-cha slide. So we're going to be moving forwards, backwards, left and right. Let's see whether you can remember.
This is something new, the Casper Slide Part 2, featuring the Platinum Band. And this time, we're going to get funky.
Doing the cha-cha slide, it's one of my favourite dances. So now we're going to use what we've learned today to answer questions. So it says, colour the circle on the left. I'm looking at that piece of paper. I'm making my L's. I know that this is my writing hand, so I know that this one's on the right and this one is on the left. So I would colour this one in. Next one, colour the square on the right. I do exactly the same thing. I'm looking at the piece of paper. I'm getting my L's out. I know this is my writing hand, so I know that this one is the one on the right. Again, I can check that. So my L means that's my left hand. So if I coloured in this one, that would not be right. Colour the stars on the right. So again, get my fingers. This is my writing hand. This is the star that's on the right. And finally, curl the triangle on the left. Fingers, which one makes an hour? Well, that one would be a backwards one. This makes the hour, so this one is the one on the left. Now we're going to have a little look at which direction the ladybird is moving. So if you're looking at the ladybird here, and you're saying, which direction is it going? Is it going from the ladybird to the left? Or is it going to the right? Or is it going forwards? Or is it going backwards? So have a look. Imagine you're the ladybird. The best thing to do is actually what you're doing now. You're facing the camera. So you can face the camera and think, oh, that ladybird is facing this way. If it was going this way, which way would it be moving? It would be moving to the left. And you can see that there. Which direction is the wasp going to? So here's the wasp. Is it going right? Is it going left? Is it going forwards? Is it going backwards? And here's the hedgehog. Which way is the hedgehog going? So again, the hedgehog is facing this way. Is it going forwards? Is it going backwards? Is it going to the right? Or is it going to the left? We have to imagine what they're that thing. So the wasp is moving forwards. The hedgehog moves to the left. So whatever way the animal or the thing is facing, you've got to imagine you're that thing. So you've got to imagine that you're that hedgehog facing this way. It's going towards you guys, so it's going to the left. Circle the creature which is moving to the left. So they're both going this way, but one of them is going to the left and the other one is going forwards. So have a little look at the position. We've got the crab. And then we've got the spider. So have a little look. Which one do you think is moving to the left? Well, if I was the crab, I'm like this, and he's moving that way, he'd be moving to the left. If I was the spider, and I'm facing this way, and I'm moving this way, I'll be moving forwards. So the crab is moving to the left. True or false, the bug is to the right of the turkey. So the bug is to the right of the turkey. So in this one, we need to underline the important information. So the bug's important. The statement is that the bug's to the right of the turkey. So we need to start at the turkey. The turkey is facing this way. So face yourself this way. And it's saying, is the bug to the right of the turkey? So if you get your left and your right arm, I know this one's my left, this is my writing arm. If it's to the right of the turkey, it's going to be here. So if we look on here, you can see the bug is to the right of the turkey. So it's true. Rhea thinks that if the turtle moves two squares to the left, it will find the grass. Is she correct? Explain how you know. Now the explain bit's really important because what the majority of you guys do will say, yes, she's correct. No, she's correct. Well, why? Why is she correct? Or why is she incorrect? So imagine you're the turtle. The turtle's facing this way, so position yourself this way. Rhea thinks if the turtle moves two squares left, she'll find the grass. So I'm the turtle. Get my left and right out. This is my right in hand, so my left is this side, so I need to go this way. And I'm going two squares. So if I'm going one, two. So if I'm my turtle and I'm going left two squares, I'd be going here, and I'd be going to another square that would be here. I definitely wouldn't be at the grass. So is Rhea correct? No. Why? And that's where we use the word because. And we spell that, big elephants can't always use small exits. So each letter of those words is used in the word because. So we've got to use the word because. So, no, because if she moves two squares left, she'd be off the grid. Or you could also say no, because what she meant to say was if she moves two squares forwards, backwards, right, which way? So if my tortoise is here, my turtle, shall I say, and it's going towards the grass, it's moving forwards two squares, one, two. So no, because Rhea needs to move two squares forwards to reach the grass. Or you could have, like I said before, no, because if the turtle moved two squares to the left, it would be on the square that I've put on the grid and it would be off the grid. Write statements using forwards, backwards, left and right to describe how each creature can get to the leaves. So this is where you can pause the video and you're going to have a turn at writing what directions each of the creatures needs to be able to get to the leaves. So we've got the ladybird. The ladybird's facing this way, needs to get to the leaves. So how is it going to get there? Does it need to move forward? Does it need to move backwards? Does it need to move to the right? Does it need to move to the left? Then we've got the bird. How's the bird going to get there? Does it go forwards? How many squares forwards does it go? So it's really important that you're being really specific. So we're going to do one with the bird together, and then I want you to have a go with the ladybird. So here's my bird, and it's got to get to the leaves. Now there are loads of different ways that I could do this, but I'm going to do the easiest one first. You could think of some more difficult or tricky paths. So I've got my bird, and it's going to go one, two squares. And if I'm facing this way as my bird, I need to decide whether I'm going left, right, forwards, backwards. So I think the bird needs to go forwards, one, two squares. So you could put bird, move forwards, two squares. Now that would be a nice easy one. You could also make it a bit more tricky. So instead of using an easy one, especially if you're in year three, I want a more complicated path. So, could it be that actually they're not allowed to go forwards for the first step? So maybe the bird has to go like that. And therefore the path would be different because the bird is facing this way. If it has to get to this square, it has to move left one square. So bird, move left one square, or actually it'd be better to write it move one square left, that's the first one. So now I'm here, so if I use a different pen, then my bird's still facing this way and I've got to get to here this time, so the bird's going to move how many squares forwards? One. So move one square forwards. Now I need to get down to here. So remember, my bird's facing this way. It's not turned around. So don't turn your bird around. Your bird's facing this way and it's got to get to here. So it's got to go from this square down to this square. So it's got to move one square this way. And again, look at your left, look at your right. Here's my left, this is my right hand, one square to the right. So, oh, move, one, and I'm going to shorten square to SQ to make it easier, to the right. Still not at the leaves yet, so I've got one more. I'm here, I need to get to here. So I'm facing this way and I need to move one square forwards. Move, one square forwards, just like that. So what I want you to have a go at now is you can do a different path for the bird and also try and do your path for the ladybird to get to the leaves and write it out. See whether you can do that. So you can pause and you can create your own path. And I've given you a special piece of paper that has this grid on it so you can physically draw it and write as well. The treasure is buried two squares left of the ship. Where is the treasure buried? Well, here's my ship and again it's facing this way. If it's two squares left of the ship, I've got my fingers, This is my right hand, so this one's my left. It's going to be one, two. So it's going to be moving up, one, two. There would be my shape. Oh, perfect. So see whether you can have a turn now at using your right, your left, forwards and backwards, in between, beside, and all of those positions to answer the questions that I've provided you. Thank you.